Hello and welcome to the Office 365 new features presentation for November 2013. If you've already viewed the new features presentation for October 2013, which was our inaugural presentation, welcome back. If not, I'd recommend going out and taking a look. My name is John Horner and I am a partner solution consultant within the Global Partner Services Division of Microsoft. I will be facilitating this presentation today and want to personally thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to sit down and take a look at what's new in Office 365. November was a busy month with almost all the different services across Office 365 seeing updates. We've rolled out updates in most of our core investment areas in November, including devices with updates to a couple Windows Store apps, Expressions with touch-oriented updates and the Office Store, Social with Yammer, Sharing, and Office Web Apps updates, Communication with Link and Outlook updates, and Control with some administrative updates I'm sure you will like. So let's take a look at our investments in these areas for November 2013. In November of 2013, we rolled out updates in our devices investment area with Link and OneNote Windows Store app improvements. We've kept a close eye on your reviews and comments in the Windows Store, as well as other channels of feedback. And based on your feedback, we've made a number of improvements that we think you'll like. Many of you have already installed the Windows update and are enjoying the new cool features of Windows 8.1. If you haven't upgraded yet, now you have another great reason. Released in November of 2013. A new update to the Link Windows Store app. It's available today and only for Windows 8.1. With this updated app, we can take control of screen shared or apps. So during a Link meeting with app sharing or screen sharing, we can take control of the sharing started by someone else in the meeting, whether it is a PowerPoint presentation or their desktop. We now have the ability to run Link side by side with another app and at any window size. So if we need to reference another app or website using Link, we can have them up side by side. We're no longer limited to the old 320 pixel snap size. We can make that Link window any size we want. The new app update allows us to answer audio and video calls from the lock screen. And we can mute and control call volume from inside Link. So we can mute the speakers or control the volume of our call from the conversation window without affecting our Windows system speaker volume. We have in-app contact search so we can find contacts faster. And this update also includes a number of improvements to the sign-in experience so that you can more easily connect and stay connected. Windows 8.1 introduced something called quiet hours that allows the user to define a period of time each day where notifications and background tasks should be suppressed. This update offers the ability to bypass these quiet hours. Early in July, we released the new versions of OneNote on iPad, iPhone, and Android. In November, we released the next major versions of OneNote for Windows Store. And we think you're going to love all the new features and functionality available in these updates. A lot of the features are based on your feedback, and we look forward to seeing what you have to say about this update. If you have an iPad, iPhone, or iPod, please download the OneNote app from the App Store, where you can get started for free. We think that once you start using OneNote to keep track of your ideas, share with others, and be more organized, you'll never need another note-taking solution. With the new version, you'll see notes the same across all clients on different platforms, whether it be Windows, Windows Phone, Android, or iOS. And yes, we will render ink on iOS devices as well. Keeping in mind how personal your note-taking is, we're also introducing several formatting options so that you can mark up your notes the way you like. With the first version of the app, you could access your notes on SkyDrive. With the updated release, we're making it easier or just as easy to access your notebooks in SharePoint, Office 365, or SkyDrive Pro. This makes the OneNote app a great way to track all of your personal and work notes in one convenient place. With so many things in one place, it's important to have an easy way to find anything. And in these updates, we're giving your ability to search across your notes as well as having a recent notes area. OneNote for iOS and Android are available for all users at no cost from the Apple's App Store and or Google Play Store, and OneNote for Windows is available at the Windows Store. Our investment in their Expressions area comes with some improvements in the Office Store and touch design. The Office Store is available to all customers of the new Office and can be accessed directly within Office applications or at office.com. Hundreds of business and productivity apps are available, and in fact, users have already downloaded well over 1 million apps from the store. In October, developers began updating and/or submitting subscription apps in the seller dashboard, and starting in November, Office Store users will be able to purchase these subscription apps. So not only are we making it easier for customers to find apps that make them more productive, we are providing an opportunity for developers who may have never developed for the Microsoft platform before. And the new development model makes it easier than ever for developers to build, run, and maintain, adding value to both their business and their customers. With the new SharePoint, we brought important innovations for how users interact with SharePoint sites and content on mobile devices. From the start, touch has been a key area of investment across all the products in the new Office, and SharePoint is no exception. Now we're making SharePoint even more touch-friendly. The new touch-designed mobile pages enhance the touch experience of two core SharePoint components, SkyDrive Pro and Sites. Now, when you access SharePoint Online from smaller devices, which would be 11-inch screens down to 4-inch screens, you have a new app-like experience that enables you to work your best with documents and team sites. Touch design creates new and improved mobile browser views and experiences for SkyDrive Pro and Sites in Office 365. The app-like design, with documents displayed as big touchable tiles on a screen, was first introduced with the recently announced OWA for iPhone and iPad. With the new touch design pages in SkyDrive Pro and Sites, you touch tiles to view your documents, documents shared with you, or documents you follow. You can also open documents or share the URL of documents with other users using touch. Last November, at the SharePoint conference, we announced our roadmap for Enterprise Social and talked about three phases of Yammer integration: basic integration, deeper connections, and connected experiences. In last month's, or October's, monthly update, we talked a little bit about that. Now let's take a look at the new November improvements to Social in Office 365. Last March, we announced the inclusion of Yammer Enterprise in the Office 365 Enterprise plans for Enterprise Agreement customers, and we touched on that in last month's update. With the November feature updates, we're excited to announce that we've expanded that program and now include Yammer Enterprise with all Office 365 Enterprise plans. As part of this update, all existing Office 365 Enterprise plan customers will receive licenses for Yammer Enterprise. As pictured on the slide, entitled customers will be able to provision Yammer Enterprise directly from their Office 365 admin portal by looking at the Included Services tab and selecting Yes, Activate Yammer Enterprise. In addition, we'll be adding three additional SKUs. There'll be a SharePoint Online Plan 1 with Yammer, SharePoint Online Plan 2 with Yammer, and also a Yammer Enterprise as a standalone SKU. We're also updating the way we look at licensing external users. We believe that people work better when they can collaborate with business contacts both inside and outside their company. Prior to the acquisition, Yammer enabled external collaboration with dedicated online workspaces called external networks. With the November feature update, Office 365 Enterprise customers are no longer required to purchase Yammer Enterprise licenses for external users within their external networks. This simple licensing change significantly reduces the friction in cross-org collaboration and will enable the end users to work with customers and partners without having to worry about additional costs. Getting work done often requires collaborating not only within your organization, but also with business contacts outside of your organization. We've been hard at work to enhance the external sharing experience so that sharing is more and more friction-free for both users and administrators. As of November, we've made improvements to SharePoint Online and Office 365 to make collaboration outside of your organization easier, including the ability to start a collaboration email with everyone when sharing a site or document. We made it easier to notify all recipients at the same time on the same email. Now, when you share with multiple internal people via the sharing dialog box in SharePoint Online, a single email message is sent to everyone you shared with rather than sending a separate email to each recipient. Important note here is that because external invitees need unique invitation links that properly route them through the external sharing process associated with Microsoft accounts, external email addresses typed in the People Picker will still send out individual external invitations. We also have the ability to create anonymous guest links in one click within the Office 365 user interface. So it's now possible to generate a guest link for either anonymous viewing or editing of documents directly from SkyDrive Pro and SharePoint Online document libraries. Just click, copy, paste, and go. When you no longer want the guest link To be active, it can be disabled at any time from the same share dialog box. And we've also added the ability to allow site members to invite external users, not just site collection owners. Much of SharePoint Online and Office 365 is about the delegation of administration duties, or empowering others to make decisions, paired with giving them the right levels of controls to do so. Site collection administrators can now allow members of the site to send a sharing invitation, both internal and external, without requiring the site collection administrator to first approve or reject the invitation request, removing a common barrier to sharing while enabling finer-grained controls. Lastly, we're adding a new tab to the Office 365 Admin Center where administrators can keep an eye on who has been invited as an external user, what email address they were invited via, and what they're using as a login credential. A document is only as good as the people who contribute to it. With the November update, we're introducing a new way for people to collaborate on documents with Office web apps. Using real-time co-authoring, colleagues, friends, and family can contribute and edit documents simultaneously in the Word web app, PowerPoint web app, or Excel web app. New real-time presence helps you see where your co-authors are working so you don't create conflicts as you edit. Additionally, the new ability to see changes to text and formatting as they happen will help you and your co-authors stay on the same page as your ideas develop and evolve. And because Office web apps now save as you go, your team's edits are included and seen as they happen. With the introduction of real-time co-authoring, the Office collaboration experience takes your ability to work with others to the next level. Whether working with the web, desktop, or Windows tablet, or iPad, maybe a mobile device, offline, online, Office provides you the tools to work together in ways that fit your needs. In addition to adding co-authoring, we've updated each of the Office web apps to bring Office experience you know and trust to the web. In Word web app, you'll get improved formatting controls for polished documents. New features include ability to find and replace words and phrases, apply styles and formatting to tables, and insert headers and footers for more professional reports and papers. In Excel web app, the new ability to drag and drop cells and reorder sheets makes it easier to work with spreadsheets online. The Excel web app gives you a quick analysis of a range of data right in the status bar, including sum, count, and average of a selected range of cells. And we now support more workbook types online. You can now open and interact with spreadsheets that you have that have sheet protection. In PowerPoint web app, new picture cropping functionality gives you more control of the visuals in your presentations. And to make managing your files online more streamlined, you can now change the name of your files within the editing window of PowerPoint web app and across the other Office web apps. So what's next from Office web apps? Over the next several months, we're going to deliver on previously promised updates. Notably, we're still on track to enable editing from Android tablets so you can access Office files and tools from even more devices. And of course, we'll continue to bring the Office features that you value most to the web so you can more easily create Office files from start to finish online. Now let's take a look at some of the communications updates included in the November 2013 updates. In the previous October update, we talked about the rollout for folder permissions in Outlook web app, the ability to give delegates access to your inbox and other folders. In November, we completed this rollout, so all Office 365 customers should now have this functionality. Similarly, the calendar delegation in Outlook web app rollout has completed as of November of 2013, so all tenants should be able to configure calendar permissions to allow delegates access to their calendars. If your tenant does not have this functionality, please feel free to reach out to Microsoft, as by now everyone should have received this functionality. One thing I'll touch on later on in the presentation, I'll touch on the end of all of these presentations, that the majority of these rollouts, when we mention them, they are beginning the rollout, so little by little tenants will be getting these, but we will, from time to time, we will let you know when these rollouts have completed as well. So part of our monthly updates will be to let you know which have completed, meaning that you should have this functionality in your tenant. Earlier, I mentioned the updates to the Link Windows Store app. In November, we also updated the Link 2013 desktop client, introducing several new features to enhance the Link user experience. We've added the the ability to have photos of senders and receiver appear within the chat. So within the IM window, we've added the capability to view photos of the sender receiver in line with the conversation. This will add a visual context to our IM conversations, particularly in conference scenarios where multiple people may be chatting at the same time. All participants in the conversations are not required to have a client with a November update for the photos to appear. Those that have the update will see the photos, while those on older clients or those that do not have the update will not see the photos. Also included in the November 2013 update to the Link Desktop client, we're adding a new capabilities which allow you to choose the resolution and size of client-side recordings. With different resolution options, the size of the recording will change so recordings which may not need to be kept in full HD will be easier to share and download via a SharePoint site or through email. With the latest update to Outlook 2013 released in November, the email message header in the reading pane can be collapsed to provide more screen space for the body of the email. Also, when the reading pane is possibly too narrow to show all recipients in the message header, an indicator appears to tell you how many recipients are not shown. And with the November 2013 updates, Outlook 2013 is now optimized for the high pixel density screens on today's tablet devices. November also brings new features and updates to the administration and infrastructure portions of Control. On the administration side, we're introducing some new Link Online login trace files and an Office 365 admin app. Before the November update, to troubleshoot login issues, you needed to run a snooper and know the name of the folder where logs are placed, requiring a great deal of time to resolve issues, in particular if the problem was with a remote client. In the November update, we've added the ability to access sign-in logs with one click. If there were no errors during the sign-in process, the logs, of course, will be empty, but if you had problems connecting to the server, the logs will show the errors and the steps Link made in order to connect to the server and results for each step, either passed or failed. An end user can easily copy the logs and send them to their IT department, significantly simplifying troubleshooting of login issues. We're working to improve the transparency of the Office 365 service by continuously improving our communication with customers on changes that impact the Office 365 environment. Included with the November updates, Office 365 service administrators can now connect to their organization's Office 365 service status from wherever they are with the Office 365 admin app. The new app enables administrators to view service health information and maintenance status updates from their mobile device. They can also filter information by service subscriptions and configure app data refresh intervals. To access service health data with the Office 365 admin app, you must have an active Office 365 subscription with administrator user rights. This app does not currently support Windows Azure Active Directory multi-factor authentication, however. The Office 365 admin app is in the process of rolling out across multiple platforms, starting with Windows Phone 8 today, and we'll follow it up with Android 4.2.1 and up and iOS 7 in the coming weeks. The November updates have also brought some improvements and new features to the Message Center. In August of 2013, we announced the availability of the Message Center, which was created to improve our communications with customers on changes that impact the Office 365 environment. Over the past few months, we have been working hard on improving the functionality. One of the enhancements included improving the visibility of Message Center by adding it to the Service Overview dashboard in the admin landing page for enterprise customers. Another enhancement that we were enabling today is the ability to send you messages that are targeted to your company. Previously, targeted messages were sent to your inbox, but now they will arrive in your Message Center, thus centralizing all Office 365 related messaging, as well as helping you manage your inbox. As before, the benefit of these targeted messages is to help us provide you with more specific instructions on how to keep your service up and running based on your specific configuration. For example, we are able to proactively notify customers using the legacy directory synchronization client that it will retire on February 31st of 2014. Our hope is that the information will empower you to proactively manage your environment. We have big plans for Message Center, including making urgent messages more visible and providing more detailed information on service updates. We will continue to keep you up to date on the latest capabilities via the Message Center. As I alluded to earlier in the presentation, These features are all in the process of being rolled out, with the exception of the folder permissions in Outlook web app and the calendar delegation in Outlook web app. So other than those two features, if you don't have them currently in your tenant, please don't be alarmed. They are in the process of being rolled out. We'll try to keep you up to date and let you know when the rollout has completed, as we did in today's presentation with folder permissions and calendar delegation. If you do not have those two certain features, please feel free to reach out to us, because you should, all tenants should have that update at this point in time. Also, please don't forget to check out the Office 365 technology blog located at http://blogs.office.com/whack/office365tech. It's the best place to find further information about the updates discussed in this presentation, as well as the best place to find information and notification of future updates. This concludes this installment of the Office 365 New Features Monthly Update. I hope you found this presentation informative and helpful. If you haven't seen the previous installments of the Office 365 New Features Monthly Updates, I encourage you to go check them out now. My name again is John Horner, and I work as a Partner Solution Consultant within the Global Partner Services Division of Microsoft. I want to again personally thank you for taking the time out of your busy day to listen in on this presentation, and I look forward to having you listen in on future monthly update sessions. So until next time, thanks for stopping by.